Hi everyone, welcome to my channel again. In this video, I'll be talking about Pythagoras' theorem. Pythagoras' theorem is actually not very complicated. All you have to do is to memorize this formula, c squared is equal to a squared plus b squared. But what is c, a, and b? C, a, and b are shown in this figure. Note that this is extremely important. This triangle is a right angle triangle. So in other words, for the Pythagoras theorem to be applicable, the triangle must be a right angled triangle. Without further ado, let's start working on example number one. For example number one, you are given a figure like this, okay? And note that this is a right angled triangle. So immediately, you know that you may be able to apply Pythagoras' theorem for this example. In this example, you are given the length of each side in terms of x. So this is x, 2x minus 1, and 2x plus 1. So by applying Pythagoras' theorem, I know that 2x plus 1, the whole thing squared, is equal to x squared plus 2x minus 1, the whole thing squared. The question is asking you to find x. So you have to solve for x using this equation here. So what you have to do is you have to expand this bracket and this bracket. So how do I expand this bracket? You need to know the identity. You have to know this identity. A plus b squared is equal to this. So by applying this identity, I can expand this immediately. So this bracket square will become 2x squared plus 2 times 2x times 1 plus 1 squared. Okay, so that's the left-hand side of the equal sign. What about the right-hand side of the equal sign? We have the x squared here, and then plus this bracket square. So for this bracket square, you need to know another identity, which is this one, okay? So by using this identity, I expand this 2x minus 1 square. So now we can do some simplification. We have a 2x whole thing square on the left-hand side of this equal sign, and we have the same thing. So both things cancel out. Okay, 2 times 2x times 1 is 4x plus 1 square, which is 1, is equal to x square minus 2 times 2x, which is minus 4x plus 1. Okay, so this 1 and this 1 cancel each other out. Okay, so now if we move this 4x from the left-hand side to the right-hand side, it will become x squared minus 4x minus 4x is equal to 0. So x squared minus 8x is equal to 0. Now we can do some simple factorization. Because both this term and this term have a common factor of x, so I'll bring the x out, so it becomes x times x minus 8 equals 0. And you know that when two things, x and x minus 8, when they are multiplied together, they are equal to 0. It means either x is equal to 0 or x minus 8 is equal to 0. But of course, we know that x cannot be 0, because if x is 0, it means that the length of this triangle is 0, which is not an acceptable answer. So this is rejected. So we're only left with this solution, x minus 8 is equal to 0. So it means that x equals 8, and that's your answer. Let's work on example number two. But before I jump into example number two, I need to tell you something more about Pythagoras' theorem. In the beginning of this video, I told you that for right angle triangle, okay, c squared is equal to a squared plus b squared. But this is only one part of Pythagoras' theorem. There's a second part about it. The second part is that if you can prove that c squared is equal to a squared plus b squared, okay, then you know that this triangle is a right angle triangle. Okay, So what this is telling you is one thing. And what this is about is actually the converse of this. On this whiteboard, I've drawn a triangle, okay? And I've given you the length of this triangle, 10, 6, and 8. So about this converse of Pythagoras' theorem, if I know that c squared is equal to a squared plus b squared, then this triangle must be right angled, okay? So why don't we take a look at it? What is c squared for this triangle? C squared is 10 squared, okay? C squared is equal to 10 squared, okay? Which is 100. So looking at this triangle again, what is a squared plus b squared? A squared plus b squared is equal to 8 squared plus 6 squared. A squared plus 6 squared, which is equal to 64 plus 36, which is equal to 100. So as you can see, c squared is equal to 100. A squared plus b squared is also equal to 100. In this case, I can draw a conclusion that this triangle is a right angle triangle because c squared is equal to a squared plus b squared. So this is what we call the converse of Pythagoras' theorem. So now let's go back to example number two. Example number two, you're given a figure like this, and this question tells you that this is a right angle. This is also a right angle. So in essence, this is a trapezoid, okay? So this question is asking you whether angle BDC is 90 degrees. So by applying this converse of Pythagoras' theorem, if you can prove that BC squared is equal to the sum of BD squared and BC squared, then we can prove that this angle is a right angle by using converse of Pythagoras' theorem. So you want to know whether... You want to know whether this is true or not, okay? You're given the length of BC. You're also given the length of DC, but you don't know the length of BD, so you need to find out BD. But how do you find BD? You can actually apply Pythagoras' theorem on this triangle ABD, okay? Because ABD is a right angle triangle. So if you know the length of AB, then you can find the length of BD. So you need to find AB, okay? But what is AB? If you look at this figure carefully, AB is actually the same as this. So let me draw out this line for you. So here, I draw a vertical line from D all the way until it meets this line BC. So I know that AB is equal to D. Let me give this point a name. Let me call this P, okay? So AB is equal to DP. So now I want to find out what DP is. It's actually quite simple because if you examine this triangle, DPC, okay? It is a right angle triangle. So you can apply Pythagoras' theorem. So DC squared is equal to DP squared plus PC squared, okay? What is DC squared? You know that DC is square root 74. So DC squared is just 74 equals to DP squared plus PC squared. What is PC? PC is actually 13 minus 8. So this is 5 squared. So DP squared is equal to 74 minus 25, which is equal to 49. So DP is equal to 7. So after knowing that DP is equal to 7, I also know that AB is also equal to 7. Okay, this is also equal to 7. So after knowing that AB is equal to 7, by looking at triangle ABD and by applying Pythagoras' theorem, I can find BD. So BD squared is equal to 7 squared plus 8 squared, okay? Plus 64, which is equal to 113. So now we can look at this equation again. We want to know whether BD squared plus DC squared is equal to BC squared. Now we have all the numbers ready, so why don't we plug in the numbers? So BD squared plus dc squared is equal to 113 plus dc squared. Dc squared is the square of square root 74, so which is 74, which is equal to 187. So what about bc squared? The question tells us that the length of bc is 13. So bc squared is 13 squared, which is 169. Okay, so are these numbers the same? Of course they are not the same. So we can answer this question. Angle BDC is not 90 degrees. So the answer is a big no. Okay, and that's your answer.